Hi everyone, thank you for joining in. I would like to present you my review of AKG K275 Closed Back Wired Foldable Over Ears Pro Studio Headphones. So without further ado, let's start from unboxing. The packaging itself is pretty standard for AKG. It's a simple carton box wrapped up in plastic. Very easy and works just fine, also very good for recycling. I've been looking around for some sort of portable closed back headphones for quite some time. Happily found this very nicely priced model from AKG. In the box we've got a paper printed manuals and warranty, as well as little instruction how to fold your headphones. Further, one plastic velvetish pouch. It's nice to have, but honestly it's not that much of protection, more of a dust cover. 5 meter long coiled high quality cable with adapter. The cable itself is quite heavy, good build. It's also very nice to see that 6.3 millimeter adapter included. And the headphones itself, of course. From the first sight, it looks like very well constructed rugged piece of pro gear. Full metal on the headband, made out of plastic, sort of fake leather, with AKG brand logo print. Very much raw model, something what you can trust, at least by the look of it. And actually just right something I was looking for. It's surely not the lightest headphones I've had. Metal frame and anodized aluminium ear cups makes it heavier, but it also brings very good sense of good build quality to it. Here's specifications. It has a very nicely soft ear pads, which is also easy to change. As you can see over here, you can very easy take an ear pad off and on, in case if you want to change original ear pads to any other suitable. There is no visual presence of plastic. It is clean, easy, modern, and somehow as serious as it can get with pro audio hardware. I'm wearing glasses quite often, so I prefer slightly larger and softer ear pads, like these ones for example. They are even a bit too soft for my liking, but it can be improved by reinforcing the backside of the ear pad with piece of leather. Little customization. You also can just purchase very good made pair from another manufacturer, including AKG made ear pads specially for this model. For some people, cables could be a big problem. Sure, that is not very comfortable, but still, that is the only way if you want to work with audio quality critical applications. It is very nice to see that AKG keeps bringing out headphones with interchangeable cables. Mini XLR is a very old hi-fi and pro audio standard, which ensures highest quality connection. There is a lot of third-party manufacturers who are making different kinds of mini XLR headphones cables. From very expensive, perfect quality, pure silver based, to seriously inexpensive but still good quality cables, as these for example, with L-shaped or straight plug. I have to say that these cables are much lighter and easier to handle than the original ones provided by AKG. A good example of exceptional quality cable would be this Pioneer made one, with L-shaped plug and 6.3 millimeter adapter. Okay, done with unboxing. Let's see how it will hold up to its promise. I've got a lot of experience with different AKG headphones. For the last 20 years, different models of AKG were my go-to headphones for many occasions. So I'll start by checking it out with some pro gear, like this Zoom U44 handy audio interface, for example. With impedance of 32 ohms only, it is very easy to drive pair of headphones. So no surprise over here. Everything adjusts as expected. Besides high quality loud, as I would dare to call it, pro grade outs, it works perfectly with lower volume systems, of course. I believe this pair of headphones would make a good match for anyone who makes music, especially on the portable devices, like Apple or Android tablets. I can say that I was trying out this pair with almost any source and situation I could lay my hands on, so to say. Even here, in case of this vintage audio machine, K275 performs very well. Somehow AKG managed to make an exceptionally versatile pair of pro closed-back headphones. I also tried to use K275 with my favorite 3-head cassette deck for monitoring audio quality and tape calibration. have to say that it did its job just as it should, never losing the opportunity to show imperfections in sound source or shining bright due to the perfect audio quality of the recording plate. Now just for fun, let's try it out with this vintage Walkman from Sony. I recently cleaned it up, so it should work almost perfectly. Now connecting a shorter cable and placing my freshly recorded on 20 years old tape playlist. And surprise, surprise, it sounds good. In fact, very good. Somehow AKG are making almost ideal pair to this vintage device. Personally, I find it really remarkable. Well done, AKG. Regarding comfort, I would like to point out that I had no complaints. Even with weight for almost 300 grams, it's still very comfortable, even for longer periods of continuous wear. So now you can imagine how excited I was about K275. Speaking of vintage, let's check out my favorite K271 MK2, which I'm personally using from 2009. I have to say that this headphones is my favorite choice regarding all audio studio works. It's just a perfect tool for many audio engineers. It's light, comfortable, and as sharp to audio quality as it gets. Also, it survived long periods of constant use without any problems besides wearing off on some parts. During those years of use, unfortunately, all three supplied cables are perished. Ear pads just decomposed at a certain point too. But the headphones itself were always working just fine. I've changed ear pads 2 times, and as I could remember, I was also buying cables many times to it. With all that so far, K271 probably would be the best ever made headphones for me. I'm still using it when I need to do critical to the audio quality work. So let's compare them one to another. K275 is heavier, seems to be more durable due to the metal build and folding design. The construction otherwise is not much different from that of K271. It is all good indeed, but what about the sound of the K275 comparing to K271? How it will hold up to the well-known high standard of the AKG powerhouse? In short, basically it is complete opposite to K271. It sounds large, full-bodied, yet transparent, friendly and open, with impressive amount of details and nuances. Just like AKG always was, it has a very 80 kind of character, even with slight extension in bass and lower middle. To be precise, bass is extended but not overpowering or fatiguing. Clear and extremely detailed middle and nicely silky kind highs. Very comfortable and engaging warming sound. As I already have said, a complete opposite to K271, which is sound razor blade, sharp, sort of cold, not very friendly, and for some people lacking seriously in the bass register. I have to say again that this is exactly the character of headphones I would want to use if I need to track audio stream for quality imperfections. K275 also sounds really nice with my high resolution audio players. I was capable to hear any of the smallest nuances of the recording plate, its character, its texture and stage presentation. Great experience overall. Besides this model, AKG obviously has many others. Currently, K371 is recommended by AKG as a flagship studio model, which is also a foldable model, but somehow the look and design of it seems to be not really something I personally would prefer, so I decided in favor of K275 to try out. I'm not disappointed for a split second. This thing rocks. And that would be all for now. Thank you very much for joining in. Thumbs up if you liked it, please subscribe and see you all next time.